is Victor?
Who is Randy?
Don't bring anyone loving to this.
Your mom in the fuck is dead.
Yeah, it's true.
It's pretty fucking
interesting. By the way, do you have any interest? Do you kind of just watch from the sidelines how things are starting to gear up for 2020 elections, and all these people are coming into the mix? Like, different people are announcing that they're going to... Right now, the pool, I don't know if you've seen the Democratic pool. It is like, it's huge, right?
I know, a lot of
every
chicks.
Every day they're announcing like all these, you know, different senators and former governors, Congress people. But there's other people that are announcing that they're going to run for president too. Like, I don't know if you've seen this guy right here. He just announced.
Hi, everyone. This is Michael Arthur Taylor Jr. I am a retiree. I am running for president of the United States.
Good. For and fucking Brody hung himself. This guy's still fucking walking around telling people. This is the problem we have. Poor Brody, rest his soul, and this guy wants to run for president. This guy can't get to the fucking store without falling down two times. And he wants to run for president. And the fact that somebody taped him and let it, this fucking moron get the platform. Like, if this guy called you up and said, come over, I want you to tape me, I'm going to run for president. Yeah, I'll be there in 2 hours. I'd send the mental health people over there. Like, listen, go over there and just bandage him up. He's talking about killing themselves and taking out a fucking Ralph's.
Right. And then somebody had to upload this to YouTube.
Yeah, yeah, like all this
some
shit.
Some asshole helped him do that.
Listen, you know what the thing is?
Fucking like, assholes.
When I came from Cuba, I looked at the presidents. You know, you had your Nixons, you had your fucking, you know, I can't even remember.
But you had Ford.
You had Ronald Reagan. You had Ford. Yeah. All of them looked like presidents.
Yeah.
And then Clinton came along and he got his dick sucked and something happened. And not that nobody else got their dick sucked.
Yeah.
He came along and it became something else. Bush didn't have it. I think Bush had it, but he didn't. Then the son, he definitely didn't fucking have it. We don't have presidents anymore. We got a bunch of jokesters.
Yeah, nobody in the pool is exciting.
Nobody's exciting, but nobody has a presence.
Yeah.
Joe Biden has a presence, but he's 2,000 years old. He's, you know, once you hit him with a challenge, you know, the Koreans are coming. They'll fucking die. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that guy never even had Korean food. You know what I'm saying? He's never been to Koreatown, that poor bastard. So these guys, you know, I need a 55-year-old that's strong, tough, virile, handsome. He'd come across.
Like a military guy. Kind of like John McCain.
Oh, like
now,
a big throwback to like a, or like if a Mattis actually ran, you know, the guy, General Mattis.
Yeah,
who was secretary. Guy like that who's like, we haven't had a general in a while. I think that'd
that's
be
what
fun.
I like.
You know who I wanted?
Man's man.
That was only, I don't vote. I'm a felon.
Yeah.
And I don't vote. Right, but there was only one motherfucker I would have ever voted for. His name was Russ Perot.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
I remember.
Here's
Ross.
Why. Here's why we have a debt.
I read his book when I was in prison, and I was never more impressed. When you
really
read his book on Wings of Eagles, it is one. If you really, really, really are an American, if you really believe that we should fuck motherfuckers up when they slip. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Like, that's him.
Fuck motherfuckers up.
Yeah.
Like, Perot was our guy. Perot's claim to fame was he owned this company. I don't know what they did.
I remember.
And his people got kidnapped in the Iraq situation or something.
Mm-hmm.
Correct me, I'm not a fucking historian.
Yeah.
And I read this book in 88. But he went to Kissinger and he went to all the heads of state and they said they really couldn't help him. And he said, okay. And he went to the people's families and he goes, I'm going to have your family back by Christmas Day. And he went and he searched for the highest ranking retired fucking killer that the military ever had. Like, he paid like $10 million. Give me the fucking codes. I want somebody who's killed 1,000 Japs, Vietnamese. He's killed everybody. Cubans.
Yeah.
I want a guy with no conscience. And he took that guy that was played by, in the movie, because they did a movie about it, he was played by a tough white dude, to train his employees. So think if you're an IT guy, like, and I come in and go, get up, let's go shoot a fucking grenade missile. he trained his guys, he trained his own employees, because Russ Perot sold them on it. Those are your brothers over there. How can you sit on that fucking desk and eat fucking crackers? Let's go. He trained them. And Christmas Eve, the 23rd, around there, they went over there and they saved his employees and he had the people back to their families.
No shit.
Something the government wouldn't even do because they don't want to cause problems.
Yeah.
Wow.
Perot got in some trouble for it. So he had some backlash.
Yeah.
But in my world, I want that backlash.
Yeah, yeah,
you went to a family and told them, no matter what, even if I got to buy helicopters, I will go over and take them myself. It takes a certain type of man to do that. He would have been a scary president.
Yeah.
There would have been like two countries left. If he was the president, it would have been like us and England. He would have blown everybody else up. Africa, Iran, the Israelis would still be around because he would have teamed up with Jews.
Yeah.
Them Jewish people know a thing or two. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Them Palestinians, just take them out right now. There would have just been parking lots all over this fucking empty fucking places smoking.
I remember like those.
He wasn't going to fuck around.
Larry King. He'd be like, now, Larry. He would, here's a problem right here, Larry. he would. It sounded like someone's uncle, you know, just shooting the shit.
He's little. He's like a little nerd.
And then at the end of everything, he would go, by the way, American people, they're paying for this with your money.
Yeah.
I'm paying for this
with
my money.
That's right. He was self-funded.
I saw what he was making at one time. Guys, it was just amazing.
Yeah.
At one time, they broke down when he was making a day.
It's got to be insane.
It was insane. Like, he had that much money. He's still alive.
By the way, did this guy have some platform that he was running on?
Who, Rush Perot?
No, no. The guy that announced his running for president.
Yeah, fucking Momo platform.
What's he actually say?
Who's this?
I don't know.
Look at him. Whoa. Can you imagine the other four idiots now? Who's going to be his vice president? A guy with a hat with a propeller on it. They're going to sit there all day. Yeah, this is what I'm going to do. Get the fuck out of here. You got to drive me crazy with this shit.
Being freedom for freedom. And I am taking the wall down.
Oh, he's taking the wall. Okay.
Oh,
so
okay.
He's got an immigration policy. That's interesting to know.
The wall, no need to be up in Mexico. The reason this is United States of America.
Hell. You know that? You're going to hell, Tom.
Who's going to hell? This guy.
He's
let me tell you. Can you imagine this poor bastard giving his first speech, and all of a sudden you just hear, and you see half his head fly off and shit, and he's still alive. I think we need a wall. Let me tell you something. They could put up 20 walls. Those Mexicans, they're worse than the Vietnamese. They'll dig up.
Yeah.
They'll dig it up, dog. I don't even know.
You can't stop that.
You can't stop people from doing what they're going to fucking do.
What they've been doing for the last 200 years.
No.
They know shit about that fucking border that we don't have a fucking clue.
You ever been to a checkpoint, Charlie, in Berlin? You ever go to Germany and Berlin?
Oh, you should gotta see me. I'm over there all the time, hanging out with Nazis. That's what I do. I go over there and talk about Jews with the Nazis. No!
If you ever get a chance, you gotta go to Berlin.
I go to Berlin, I tap them on the shoulder. What do you think of those Jews, huh? What the fuck is wrong with you? I don't go to Germany.
But if you ever end up in Berlin, you got to see the checkpoint, Charlie. It's the place where you could cross between East and West Berlin because they built a wall. That's what they did after the end of the war, whatever.
The Krauts.
The Krauts did it, yeah. And you would see, there's a museum right there, and it shows exactly how everybody fucked the wall, basically. Like, people would sneak in, they'd build compartments, secret compartments in trunks. They'd build secret compartments under cars and carriages, and people still fucking snuck in. I mean, there's museums dedicated to it, so you can't stop anybody.
No.
It's never gonna fucking...
No, you can't. You can't.
Jump over and get shot. People fucking...
They'll just
do it. Mexicans, did you watch that last season of Narcos?
Diego Luna. Awesome. Amazing.
Just tremendous. But it tells you that they didn't give a fuck. They'll build tunnels.
Yeah, man.
They'll go down they'll figure it out. Submarines. They don't give a fuck. It's such a, you got to pick your battles. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I have nothing against the wall. If you think the wall is that discriminating, build the fucking wall. But you're not going to stop it. You're not going to stop it.
Hello, and thank you for watching that highlight. If you want to see more of those, we have them. They're provided for you. So enjoy. Just do a deep dive like you're trying to study us. Click on these and subscribe. Hit the subscribe button and then they'll just be delivered to you. You can watch them when they come out. Please do it.